Man, when we first got to the airport, I was pretty nervous just getting off and having to go through customs and everything.
The first thing I noticed was the temperature. It was really hot.
The 4-hour drive here was really cool to see all of the small shops and just to see the culture. And once we got here, I was amazed seeing the big tree right away.
Yesterday when we arrived in Sabana Grande, we were greeted by our host families and they were so warm and welcoming. And we came and had some amazing food for lunch and then got a tour of Solar Central.
The thing that stood out to me the most about the center over here was the way they filter the water, using the sun just to heat it up, and it flows down the canals.
And it's just like incredible what Grupo Fenix is doing here.
It was definitely hard to talk to my family at first because I ran out of my vocabulary really quick.
My Spanish is decent, but it definitely isn't fluent or even close to that. So, we started off, and I didn't really know what we were doing. Julian kind of just walked us around and showed us different plants and everything, and I was picking up maybe half of them. But we just kept going up and up and up and up, and I kept asking him Mas Alto, which is more tall, and he said, see, and just pointed up.
When we first took a class learning how to wire everything, and then we were able to apply it the next day. A group of 7 of us went out to a local house that was fairly isolated from the main community and helped to install a solar panel along with lights and a battery so that they could have lights at night.
That was a lot of fun because the journey there, we got to ride in the back of the truck and just hold on for dear life. It was a blast and everyone was laughing. You know, you kind of got a duck when branches are coming your way, so people got hit in the face. And then we had to stop the car on the mountain because it literally couldn't go down this hill. It was too steep, so we had to get out, carry everything the rest of the way. It was really, really cool. I really enjoyed being at that house.
The hands-on stuff was really cool because as a freshman, I didn't necessarily get all that hands-on work during the school year. These people had been living their whole lives and had no power and no electricity and no lights.
After we had finished, and I was like, we just gave this family the ability to see in the dark.
You know, bringing electricity to homes that have never had it before is a pretty cool feeling. The people that we were installing the stoves for already did have stoves, but the fact that we were installing, you know, something a little bit better, we get to get our hands dirty with the clay and the brick and kind of make a more efficient cooking environment for them.
And it's a really cool process because, you know, they don't have like ovens like we do back home with electricity and you just turn a knob. They literally have to build a fire and keep it contained in the oven. I think I got more dirty doing that than any activity I've ever done in my 21 years of existence. It was, you literally just like play in the dirt and play in the mud and put it together and come up with a skeleton.
So we placed a layer of bricks, filling the gaps in with the cement. And then we put cement on top of those bricks, and inside was filled with pumice stones because they help transmit the heat a lot better than what has been previously used. And then we put on the chimney. And so then we lit a fire in it.
And it's a lot safer because now instead of smoke just staying in the house and turning the ceiling black, we put a chimney up and it just goes into the atmosphere. So it's a lot safer for the family because they don't have to breathe in the dust. Yeah, I kind of felt like they just were telling us what to do. And to be honest, for a lot of that, I had no idea what the purpose of what we were doing was for. I heard insectos, so I'm assuming it was for some sort of insecticide. but they kind of had us pick leaves and put it in this grinder, and it was really disgusting. They had us put it in this huge bucket and add water to it, and then I got to stir everything, and they wanted me to squeeze it all out, and it was squirting all over my shirt and everything. It was really kind of gross, but they said good work after I was done, so I guess I was doing something right.
My favorite part has been going to Samodo Canyon, where we hiked a little bit and then swam. It was a great way to just kind of experience the amazing sights in nature.
It was pretty cool, and it was a good team bonding experience. Everyone got some laughs in and made fun of each other. It was just a lot of fun.
I have been eating the Nicaraguan food all week, but I had no idea how to prepare any of it. And it was super cool to see behind the scenes.
The food's been awesome. I mean, it's been kind of, I guess, traditional Latin American food, rice and beans, a lot of chicken, then corn tortillas, obviously, the best part. I've been a fan.
It's definitely different than being at home. None of our cell phones work, and we have to make sure everyone knows the plan before we leave for our houses at night. But it's really cool and almost like freeing to be just cut off from technology.
Learned a lot of new stuff. Got some cultural experiences that you know will never experience outside of here. Had to brush up on some Spanish, which was very fun.
So to come here and really understand what I learned in the classroom connects to people's lives was a very cool experience.